Hello again, my friends. My name is Zygouris. I'm an informatics professor. This is my YouTube channel and you are on videolearning.com, my private site. So we're going to discuss today about packet switching. Previously, we discussed about circuit switching. There's some difference between these techniques of switching. Okay, this is packet switching. Imagine that we have a computer. Let's say that we have some data as a packet to transmit, so we transmit them to our router and we make this one is switching this one. Okay, so we're forwarding this package among this cloud, so finally arrives at destination station. So switching, this is switching, and the packet goes through the cloud. So we have some transmission among this network. We don't want many packets to be stuck in a node, in a router, for example, okay? And we have to make some packet switching to receive a packet and we send this packet. As we have seen in previous paragraph, a basic feature of circuit switching network is that any call made by its specific network resources, circuits and lines, who cannot use any other station to communicate. Here it is, we have a path, we have a circuit switching. Okay, so we have a path. In telephone communication, we use this circuit switching technique, and there is a large user proportion of these resources, since most of the time either one or the other interlocutor speaks. So, however, as the circuit switches began to be used for data communication, for example, to send images, to send video, to download something, two things were perceived. First, in a regular communication of computer user, the way in which data is exchanged, for example, data is transmitted, is such that most of the time the line is not used, so wasting valuable network resources. Okay. Thus, it becomes clear that in data communication, the circuit switching technique can be made ineffective. Doesn't worth it for data. Okay, we don't like that for data communication. So, secondly, a circuit switching network provides connections such as which allow the transmission of data at a constant rate, at a constant speed. Thus, each of the communication devices must send and receive at the same rate. Okay, be aware of that. Remind us, synchronous communication service that is used in telephone networks. So, this limits the ability of network to finally interconnect different computers and in general a variety of equipment. So, what is packet switching? Let's now see the second switching technique, that the packet switching solves the above problems. So we have slicing the data, like here, into boxes, into packets. The messages to be transmitted are divided into small numbers of bytes or sliced, okay? The typical maximum packet length is 1000 bytes. Each packet contains part of useful user data and more, a destination address, and a sequence number, okay? Its network node, also called packet switching node, PSN, use the destination address of the packet to decide which node it will forward. The packet serial numbers are used by the destination station to reconstruct the original messages from the pieces it has received in the packets, as you see here in the animation. Here we have a PSN. Okay, this is the packet switching node here, a router, for example. Okay, be aware of that. The data is sliced, having a sequence number, an IP address, and we have the data in the final destination station. So let's look at the packet switching process with the help of the figure. Station A wants to send a message to station E, so the message is sliced into packets, and packets are sent one at a time from station A to the switching node K1 to PSN, with which it is connected. So when the node receives the entire packet, it examines the destination address and forwards switch it to another switch node, let's say K2 PSN. So we have a switching packet. This process is repeated until the packet arrives at the destination station. Each node decides how to forward, how to switch the packet, how to move the packet, by looking at the destination address, IP address, and traffic information on network nodes. Note that each node moves the packet to a next node only after it receives the entire packet. That is why the technique is called packet switching with store and forward. So the packet switching technique has a considerable number of advantages over the Zygouris switching. First of all, there is a better use of communication lines. This is because each line can be used to transmit packets from different connections, okay, as needed, so that no time intervals where the line remains untapped. Okay, here it is, packet switching, PSN. So we have a better use of communication lines, no time intervals. Okay, here it is, the reconstruction. Okay, and we have our data, for example, a PDF file. Okay, it's very simple. So there it is, sliced, numbers, IP, and we have the reconstructions. Very simple. Another time, this is packet switching. Okay. Instead, dedicated line capacity is allocated to the circuit switching in a connection, which cannot use any other connection. Thus, if the connection remains silent for some time, the line capacity remains untapped. So we have a better use of communication lines. In a packet switching network, a data rate can be converted indeed to stations with different speeds can exchange packets, since each one is connected to the corresponding node at the appropriate speed. Another advantage is that when the traffic in a circuit switching network increases too much, so we have many calls, cards may be blocked. Okay. This means that the network rejects additional connection calls until the network load decreases, lines are released. So instead of packet switched network, still appears packets with increased delivery delay at their destination. Okay, a priority seam can be implemented. Thus, if a node has a number of packets waiting to be transmitted, can transmit the high priority packets first. These packets will obviously be less delayed to process than the lower priority. So maybe we have some packets with a high priority, so we send them first. And we have the packet switching again. Like here. See this animation to keep in mind. Okay. And look at the data. Okay, see the animation another time. Maybe we have some packets with a high priority. Okay, this is the packet switching technique. See this animation, have a look to keep in mind. It's very easy. Okay, Okay, so we have circuit switching, we have packet switching, and packet switching is divided in two kinds, to datagram and to virtual switching. We're going to discuss in the next lesson. So we finish our lessons. Thank you for watching us. Thank you from Spiros Zygouris and videolearner.com.